Okay, so first for the bench, we're gonna go ahead and do the top of it first, okay? So the top of the bench is gonna consist of a total of 5 boards, okay? So it's gonna be 3 long 2x5 boards and then 2 15-inch 2x5 breadboards, okay? So the 3 2x5 boards, two of them are gonna get the about 6 or 7 pocket holes along the entire bottom of the back of the boards. Okay, and then they're also gonna get 1 pocket hole at each end going vertically. The third one, so that's gonna be 2 out of the 3. The third one is only gonna get 2 vertical pocket holes, 1 at each end, and that's it, okay? So I'm gonna show you exactly why that is when we go ahead and drill all of our nails in and connect it all together. But for the meantime, let's go ahead and get some pocket holes drilled in here.
She looks like the girl of my dreams, yeah. She looks like the girl of mine. She looks like the girl of mine. She looks like the girl of my dreams, yeah. She looks like the girl of mine. She looks like the girl of mine.
Okay, so once you have all of your pocket holes drilled into your boards, it's time to connect them. So make sure that you lay them out on a flat level surface. Lucky for me, my garage floor passed the level test. So my boards are laid out here. I went ahead and put the 2.5-inch pocket hole screws that I'm using into all of the holes already. I haven't drilled them in yet. We'll do that shortly, but I wanted to show you how they are positioned. So these screws will go ahead and screw right in here. When they are screwed in, they'll drill right into the next board, which is gonna connect them there. You're gonna do this along the entire board in all of the drill holes. And then showing why we didn't do the pocket holes on the top board here, that's because there's no additional board up top, right? So there's nothing for any screws to drill into. So I also wanted to show you the vertical pocket holes, and the reason why for them is because they're going to connect our breadboard here. So here, so that you'll have a nice frame for your legs here. Okay, so for this next one, to go ahead and build the base for the legs, you're going to take that 9.5 board there that you cut. You put 2 pocket holes on each side. I like putting mine 2 on one end and then 2 on the other hand, just to give it a good balance. You're gonna use the 2.5-inch pocket hole screws, and then you're also gonna use wood glue. You're going to put wood glue right on the inside here and here, and then you will just drill these right into the sides of the leg. Okay, so you cut 2 of the 1x4s now. These are gonna be the last 2 pieces that you should have left. You're gonna use the short one to go ahead and apply as the short runner. You have the runners up here, the runner connectors here, and then your short runner is going to have 2 pocket holes, and you're gonna drill it right into the runners on each side. Okay, so the last step in building the bench here is to attach the bench top to the frame. So you're going to lay your bench top upside down on your leveled surface, and then you're going to take the frame, you're going to flip the frame upside down and attach it on, and you put it on top of the bench top. You're going to use wood glue underneath first, and you're going to attach it using wood glue first, and then use 1.5-inch to 2-inch wood screws. And you're gonna screw them all along the framing right into the bench top. And then you've got a bench.